Hey everybody, this is JTB.
And this is Bigalski.
And we're back for chapter 12 for the normal tutorial run. As mentioned, this is a long one. It's a good 40 minutes. Two fiend challenges, neither of them are cut down. So yeah, it's pretty long. This is a long chapter. And there's a lot of fights. Fortunately, you can save a lot, but you should be doing all the town fights in this chapter. I say should. According to the game, you actually shouldn't be, but we're not going to pay attention to that. For points, you definitely want to do them in this chapter as you have the most time. Ignore that. I'll correct that. The nunchucks aren't in this chapter. Must have forgot to edit that one. People won't see this, so it's great. I can edit that before people see the video.
But now they're going to know. You should put a little frowny face.
Oops. That is definitely the wrong score, as is that. If you finish chapter 12 with 3 million on a karma run, you've done something very wrong. But... yeah, you guys won't know what we're talking about, but that's just me goofing in the editing. So there's a couple of things to mention in chapter 12 right off the bat. We've mentioned it at the end of the last one, but this is the last chapter where you need to pick up scarabs, because past this point, you know, no scarab reward is really worth it for a karma run, you know, unless it's going to get you more points. There's no point spending time to get that stuff, so you can just skip them. One thing to note when you go to the first fiend challenge, I mean, you can do these fiend challenges in any order you want. I just prefer to do the imp challenge first more often than not. But if you do want to do the imp challenge first, when you go back up through the elevator here and then go over the stadium, make sure you hug the left wall and go along the wall and the platforms. If you run through the middle of the middle of the actual stadium, you'll trigger the actual fiend challenge to start. So like hug this wall here. If you just stay to where the different coloured floor is, like where the tile is, just stay on there. Jump round this way, and then you can just skip that, and then just go here, and then you can do the imp challenge first. But again, that's really just personal preference.
I usually picked that scarab up, you know, while you were doing it in the other chapter, just thought I'd point that out. I'm preparing myself mentally for 40 minutes.
So I think this, if I remember rightly, this goes really well, this fiend challenge. So I was trying to time my jump there. Fortunately, they all just stand there like idiots and let me charge a UT, which they don't normally do, which is great. But yeah, I had this idea with the Luna, because the Luna's animation time is actually one of the shortest UTs in the game. The only thing that makes it a little bit annoying in terms of short time limits is, as you can see there, look, it knocks them far away. You know, it has a knockback animation. Unless you knock them into a wall, it takes a while for them to dissolve, so you can't get your UT charge normally. However, when you've got celerity, you can do that, because it decreases the charge time. So this was just an experiment, and I think this ended up going so well, I just kept the run. I just got so many, I think I got like over 200k in UTs here. You can use a couple of sweet spots. There's one near the door. There's one near the stairs where you first start. But again, this fiend challenge, the spawn patterns will move as you do it. So you do have to kind of keep up with the enemies. And there is a lot of points in this. They do give you a lot of time. So you do want to kind of get in that like 40-ish UT range. So...
is this what's been shown before? I thought it was just like Dobby UTs or something like that. Is this the first time this has been shown that you've seen?
I think so, yeah. That's always annoying. One good thing about when you have the UF, though, if that whiffs, you can just whip it out. But I calmed down there and thought, nope, just use the sweet spot. This is kind of a backup. This also shows why I'm not a big fan of that sweet spot on any difficulty below very hard, as if one of those UTs kills three imps, that's really not good. Like, right there. Like, with the Luna, that still probably would have killed two, but if it kills two, it's fine, because then you can just UT the third guy. But if it kills all three, then, you know, that's potentially two UTs you've lost. So to lose 10,000 points, you know, kind of in the blink of an eye, that's really not what you want to have happen. So that's why I kind of prefer using this. You could also use the Dragon Sword, Gleaming Blade technique that I showed in Chapter 10. But again, you know, the Luna just was working so well. It just kind of kept using it. And it being level 1 really helps as well. If it was level 2, like, it'd just destroy these guys. So
it's funny knowing when to go back to, you know, the Dobby, or, you know, to do this or go back to the Lunar. That's just something that you have to kind of get a feel for.
Yeah. So here I swap over to the Dragon Sword and Gleaming Blade as the time's getting a little bit low. We're like approaching 100 seconds and I've still got 30 of them to kill. And again, if you can get kind of a really good chain of just, you know, smoke bomb, gleaming blade, smoke bomb, gleaming blade, as I do here, like, you can actually rack up your UTs pretty quick here. It just depends on how they spawn. Fortunately, I get pretty lucky looking at this, in that they actually keep spawning, like, around this area. It takes a while for the spawn pattern to move, you know, to the other side of the stairs going up to the core.
So when did you decide, okay, now it's time for Bobby, is there a certain time limit or certain amount of UTs that you've already counted in your head, so to speak?
It's mainly when I run out of smoke bombs, because the one great thing about the Debilero is you can just put distance between yourself and the imps, and the imps' AI, more often than not, except that point, when there's one left, they tend to wait for the other guys to spawn before they come at you. So if you kill two, or you kill one, just jump away from them, and then the ones that are left will wait for the other guy to spawn, so you don't need a smoke bomb. Again, fire wheels are really great if you haven't got smoke bombs and you just want to charge. The enemies on normal are a little bit less aggressive anyway, so it makes it a little bit more reliable. I fucking hate it when they do that. I also hate it when Ryu targets the one that's underground and not the one that he could have hit.
Right.
But still, that is very frustrating.
So how many UTs do you end up getting overall?
I'd have to go back and check. Oh. I think I came in on 11... What did I come in on? 11.4 something?
Oh man, you're... Oh. I'm surprised, to be honest with you, that you didn't start over. But you're not going... You're going for
10%. Oh yeah, yeah. See, I'm not going for max. I mean, if I was starting over, I probably would have reset right at that first UT that just completely whiffed. So I'm using my incendiaries here just to kind of stagger my essence and kill these guys a little bit faster. I can't remember if I make the time bonus. I think I just make the time bonus, like, really, really close. The reason I swapped to the windmill shuriken there is, I think, one of these guys coming up. Yep. So I don't cling to the wall right there. Just armor through that, it doesn't matter. I mean, you can just UT and ET here. So I think this whiffs. Yeah, that whiffs. I released that just a little bit too early, and I think this just makes it. Yeah, look at that.
Oh, 10 points
on it.
Yeah, 1/100th of a second.
So, but wow. that's a good example, really, of that. Like, that went super, super well until I ran out of smoke bombs. When I ran out of smoke bombs, that kind of went to shit. Like, I was getting steady UTs in with the Luna, and then I swap over to the Dragon Sword, getting steady UTs in with the Gleaming Blade, but then all it took was just a couple of bad spawns, a couple of UTs to whiff, and then that was it. Like, you know, that kind of killed that. Like, that could have been way better. So here, this is going to be the other Fiend challenge, so just let these guys hit you and get down to where your health bar, you know, pulsates.
Did I tell you how I am? Once I find my health bar like I want, I always go back and save. That way I don't have to mess with it again.
I usually do, but the imps aren't that bad for, like, getting your low health. Against, like, the commando fiends, I always do that, but they're okay. They're pretty consistent. So this fiend challenge is pretty straightforward, really. It's kind of boring. But you definitely want to make sure you get 50 UTs. So I'm at 11.668 there. So, again, just add on 250 and then, you know, kind of keep an eye out for that. I'm not sure... I honestly can't remember what kind of the usual method is for this fiend challenge. But I think on my no-reset run, I think I just used UF UTs. And then, you know, like, charged from, you know, celerity and upwards. But I feel like this is a little bit better way of doing it, because when you're at this health, say 8 times out of 10, these guys are going to give you a health orb. It takes 3 to 4 Debilero UTs to kill them. So you can, you know, kill 2, stagger them, get your UT, kill the guy you've just UT'd, stagger, windmill shuriken there, otherwise I'd have jumped into the fire. Just keep that in mind, as that will mess up just your essence timing. And then, yeah, just, like, farm a few Debilero UTs here and there. And I seem to finish it, like, really quickly, so I don't know if that's necessarily better or...
I think what people have done in the past is, you know, platform, like, you know, just stand there and on the platform and charge, you know, like, get, like, maybe 30 UTs or whatever on the platform, and then just go down and fight everything with the low health, whatever's left.
Yeah, but I think that guy's...
But you really got to plan that out, though, because you surely don't want to... not have enough.
So if you notice, that fiend that just died at the back there, that UFUT actually did kill him. But we've mentioned it before, how sometimes you can kill these guys with a UT, but they just go back into like their fire breathing attack, even though they're actually dead. However, your UT can still hit them, and you'll still get UT points for it. So keep that in mind if you ever see it happen.
Well, if you kill them also, and you think that, okay, I killed them, let me turn around and go someplace else, and they decide to breathe their fire, you know, that fire is going to hit you.
Yeah.
And then you're going to probably, you know, use your rebirth.
So I think here might be, yeah, I think here might be where I decide to farm. So I think here I was just looking at my, I was just looking at my UTs. So I came in here at 11,668, so I'm almost at 20 UTs, and I've killed 16 of them. So that's really, really good. So at this point, I can get in a few extra UTs. With Celerity, you can back-to-back charge two UTs every 10 seconds, give or take a tenth of a second, if you just keep your eye on the clock. So if you just watch it from now, start charging at 287. First UT. Just the second UT will connect at 280. So, like, 8 seconds, that, maybe 9 seconds, depending on how you look at the charge time. So you can get your UTs in here really, really fast if you can just, you know, hold down Y and just keep charging them back to back. But then you don't want to get into a situation where you've got, say, 45 UTs, but you've only killed, you know, 30 fiends, because then you've still got half the fiend challenge to do, but you've only got 5 UTs together.
Some of it is boring, folks. I mean, that's just, yep. That's part of the karma. Yeah, man.
You guys wait till the Master Ninja tutorial comes out. we got like a good half an hour in this fight. The Berserkers, and it's literally the same 5 moves over and over again. it's forward Y, UT, forward Y, counterattack 120 times in a row.
Now that's if you do it with the low health UF. The fast way.
That is the fast way, and it still takes half an hour.
Yeah. I did have a friend of mine fight this the stadium challenge on Master Ninja and Chucks, and it gives you the 5,000 seconds, and he actually didn't make the time limit.
Oh, that's crazy. So as you can see here, I'm swapping over to the UF. We're approaching 200k in UTs, which is 40 UTs, so... one UT with the UF, odds are you're going to kill at least one of these fiends. But if you get a good spawn and kill two, great. If you get a really good spawn and kill three, even better, but it's not going to happen very often. But fortunately, on normal, like one forward Y, even without Armor of the Sun, will just take one of these guys out straight away. You can also counter-attack their that attack right there, like whatever you want to call that, like their Sonic... their Sonic the Hedgehog roll. and you can also counter-attack their swipes, where they, like, you know, claw at you twice. You can counter-attack both of those. So if you do miss that for whatever reason... I love it when they do that. It's so funny. Nope, I changed my mind. I'm not actually
right.
Attacking.
I just explained. You know, it's funny, a while ago... You got a little fortunate to kill two with that UT, and I was like, wow, because I thought the other guy was going to get out of the way. Just in time, it's like, hey, all right, that's one of those great opportunities where you kill two with one UT and then the next one whiffed.
Yeah.
That's so, part of it.
So as you can see here, just keep an eye on your score look. Swap over to the Billero to get a couple of quick UTs as I'm at, I think that's just over 220k or just under. So I've got like, you know, 7 to 8 UTs potentially, and I've got 11 guys. If I get unlucky here and kill, you know, 3 guys with one of these UTs, that's not really what I want, because then I'm going to have to get, you know, one UT per enemy, and I don't really want to farm. So just kind of swap over here and get some UTs in where you can and stagger your essence. Always keep, you know, always keep it in the back of your mind what essence you have out. You know, the worst thing you want to do is, like, roll jump away thinking you've got 2 essence out, and you've only got 1, and then you get an ET. Getting 50 UTs on normal, like, there's not many fiend challenges where that's viable, so the ones where it is viable, you really want to get all 50 of those UTs. I hate it when they do that. So if I remember rightly, I think I came in at 11,668, so 918 would be 50 UTs. When you're going to be using a weapon that gives you a lot of combo points, always kind of estimate one under, but as you can see there, 918 is 50 UTs, as these guys don't really give you anything in combo points. But, you know, finish with 90 seconds left, could probably do it a little bit quicker. But, you know, that's all for other people to figure out, really.
Right.
I think there's a Life of the Thousand Gods in that chest. I don't bother getting it. As your health bar at this point in the game on normal, like it's more than big enough for what you really need it for. If anything, it might even be a little bit too big for normal. But if you knew, you know, it's your first calm run, you might want to grab that.
Well, you know, that's part of it too. With me, I always grab them because it's like, man, I did all this work. I'm going to get my prize.
Yeah, it's true, but it's wasted time when you think about it.
Well,
yeah, like if you
got plenty of time, but, you know.
It's true. If you do every fight, though, you do have to be still pretty quick. I forgot there's purple zombies in this chapter. I don't think we've shown them yet. God, I hate them. They have so much health. It's unbelievable how much health those guys have.
I remember when Shinobi made a video showing 999 yeah. hits on the purple zombies. It's too bad that video is lost.
If there was, I always find it funny, you know, if there was, like, NGB HD released and there was achievements, you know there'd probably be something in there for a 999-hit combo, and you know everybody would just use the purple zombies. Depending on how these guys spawn, you can just get one UT there. Because this is a fairly light gauntlet, it's only two fights, you're probably best, you know, trying to get both there. But I always thought it'd be a really fun achievement to have of do... like two fiend sealers with the low health UF and have the enemy not die, because most people would think, like, what enemy can we do that on? Like, nothing can survive that, you know? And it's the purple zombies, like, they're the only enemy that can survive two low health UF fiend sealers. So I got actually quite lucky there that the fire wheels really cooperated and I got a blue, so I actually got an extra ET in there. Usually you just want to play it safe, you know, and get two UTs. These commando fiends can go through your fire wheels whenever they want. This really is just a case of, you know, grinding it until you get, you know, where you knock them away every time. Unfortunately.
That's one of those cases where you don't need to worry about dragging essence into that, yep. because the timer doesn't start until you look at them.
Yeah. So that right there, that was in the wrong order. I wasn't paying much attention there, really, in hindsight. Because he gave me a blue, I should have done a Gleaming Blade UT on that last guy, and then I could have forward wide him and ET'd him. Got a sneaky ET in there. But I wasn't thinking when the blue came out. Sometimes they'll let you charge an ET. Sometimes they won't. These guys are really annoying. I hate them. So I think this fight is quite tricky to get much more than one UT out of. You probably could, thinking about it, if you came in with like a level 2 heavy weapon. One thing I did actually have an idea about messing with was upgrading my Warhammer to level 2, just for these guys, because then you'd still have, you know, the level 1 Debilro for like a super fast, super weak UT, but you'd have a fast UT that could one-shot those guys. But in the end, it didn't really work out. Beneficial.
I remember on the one video where you showed coming out the other side where the lily key is.
Yeah, that was in HP1.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You could still do that in this chapter, but the process of like actually getting that pattern is a lot longer. Like that takes you about an extra 30 or 40 seconds to do that. And I don't think it made much of a difference on it, to be honest.
Okay.
So I released that one a little bit early. You can delay that if you want. To just, you know, kill all three, but you know, you can pretty easily just juggle this guy. If you're not comfortable doing on landing forward Y like that, just do like XY, you know, XX, and then on landing Gleaming Blade, you'll kill him and you'll still make the time bonus. But that's a pretty easy extra UT to get. There, I was gonna fill up on Nimpo, but because I need my low health UF for the purple zombies, I actually decided not to. I decided to save it. So come out here, just let these guys hit you, and then it's purple zombie time.
Well, the other part of that too is you're gonna be burning some essence anyway. So if you bought a devil yep. elixir or a great devil, you know, keep you from having to do that later on.
Exactly. One good thing, actually, I'm thinking about it now that you mention essence. One advantage to using the Debilro and the feet and not, you know, the Dino Fiend challenge is if you do that Fiend challenge with the UF and get tons of UT kills, you'll actually have a lot of money to burn at the end of the chapter. So this fight is just really frustrating because of how much health these guys have. These guys are the king of this attack, surely going to kill him, and it doesn't, and you fail the time bonus.
Right.
So just come up here, try and take out two, or like significantly weaken two and kill one, And then just swap over to your Debilero and just charge UTs. Fortunately, zombies are really straightforward to charge with heavy weapons. If your UT animation stuns them, so that animation right there, where you actually get a reaction from them, you are guaranteed that you can charge your next one, and there's nothing they can do about it, even if they are right next to you. That attack right there, if you get that kind of pattern, again, you're guaranteed you don't need to jump away. The only way you'd need to jump away is situations like that, where you know you're not going to have the time to just charge a UT in his face.
Just to make sure.
Just to make sure, yeah, because I mean, think about it, that guy's already had, does this kill him? Yeah, it does. I had some runs where they took two UF UTs and like 3 to 4 Debilero UTs. And then I swap back to the UF, you know, for the second UT, and think, oh, this has got to kill him. And it doesn't kill him. And I'm thinking, wow. Like, what? Like, you know, come on.
Do you
let
your drawbridge down now?
No, I think I do that in chapter 13. Okay. Yeah, you should do it in this chapter, really, though. Although, it takes a few seconds.
I mean, it doesn't really matter, but still.
You know, not a huge deal. They're already dead. Yeah. You know, I've never tested this. Something I'm going to go and test when I get a chance is test those guys on Ninja Dog and see if they can still survive 2 UF Fiend Sealers. Because I don't know if any of you guys have seen a UF Fiend Sealer on a clone or a boss, but it hurts. It does like 90% damage to a boss, and they can survive 2 of them. It's kind of crazy. I've always liked this cutscene, even though I skip it. But like, you know, when you go back, I just thought it was a nice touch, you know, the first time you see it, you know, like,
right,
like it turns out Muramasa, you know, he knows about the dragon sword and he knows about, you know, the dark dragon blade and all that stuff. But that was cool. I buy the map, buy Armlet of the Moon, Izuna drop, that's just burning some essence, like some really easy essence. So there's your Armlet of Fortune, 40 scarabs. You really don't need to pick up anything else. To be honest, the Armlet of Fortune isn't essential. You don't need it at all. But it just helps take advantage of those in those instances where you get lucky and you get a red. If you've got two Nimpo orbs available, you think, oh great, you know, that's two Nimpos. You know, better to have two than one. So it's not essential, but again, it's just nice to have.
No, what I was saying earlier, again, if you're burning essence, you could have just filled up with a great spirit and a great devil and then just bought those to burn instead of going up to the thing to refill it. And that's a little time too.
Yeah, so
not much.
There is a scarab in the water down below. Again, you can grab it if you want. You've definitely got time. There's a great spirit elixir in that chest. Again, you've got loads of time in this chapter. You don't really need to worry about it too much as long as you're not wasting time, you know, doing other stuff. As long as you keep it pretty trim, you'll be fine regarding time. This fight is a huge pain in the ass. I've never been a fan of this fight. On every difficulty, this fight sucks. Every single difficulty. This is just not a fun fight. Sometimes he will delay and let you charge a full UT. Unfortunately, he didn't there. Neither does that guy. Just getting ETs. I do like that nice touch where, like, you know, when they go underground, like that little aura is blue in the core. I thought that was in the caverns rather. It's a nice little attention to detail on top of their head. And it's kind of weird that they took out the. Like the ice and magma fiends in black. If anyone's played NGO4, you get fiends that basically are the same kind of enemy as these guys, but they're like way more armored, like they've got way more spikes all over them, you know, they look a little more dangerous, and they hit like absolute tanks. That bite grab they do right there on very hard in NGO4, no joke, at this health, that about kills you. It does that much damage.
Right.
It is insane. But yeah, they took them out of this, which is odd. So that right there, just as I said, more often than not, they're going to give you blues. So just keep an eye out for it, and you'll get that like that kind of muscle memory down to, you know, you see the blue, and then as soon as you see the blue, you release the ET, jump away, get your UT. It's just something that you'll develop, you know, as you play for karma a bit more.
It's the ice fiends and the fire ones. They, like you said, they take them out. The ice ones aren't in mission mode, but the other ones.
Yeah, the magma fiends are still in there. Yeah, but the ice ones are. So the reason I throw shurikens there is just to like time the on landing like really precisely. You can just jump down, but the camera angle makes it a little bit tricky. So I just like to just toss those shurikens so I know when I'm going to hit the floor and I can do my own landing. This is the second gauntlet in the chapter. It's the only other one. You can save after these fights. You've got more than enough time. However, in order to get the most amount of points out of these fights, you do need to chain essence to them. And if you're going back and saving, these don't respawn on the way out. They respawn on the way out, but not on the way in. So you have to actually chain essence on these. I could have ET'd this guy, but I didn't want to risk it. Just counter-attack him with the UF would easily kill him.
Could you have scooped him and then ET'd?
Oh,
but then you don't have two.
Definitely.
You don't have two for here.
Yeah, exactly. That was actually a really lucky spawn. This fight can be quite tricky. So again, there, just take the hit. Just hold down block. If you ever do need to do anything like that, just when you get hit, make sure you hold block still. Even though you're getting hit, hold block. And then, like, when you're charging a UT, for example, you're holding the left trigger. When you get hit, keep the left trigger held, because if you let go of that left trigger, you'll absorb the essence. And the reason you take the hit is so you can just get up and UT. But if you let go of block when you get hit, you'll actually absorb that essence.
Yeah, that's the one thing you kind of hate. Or absorbing essence when you don't mean to.
Yeah. They changed the timing for that, too, in Sigma, like, ever so slightly. And that was always something that, whenever I'd go from, like, black to Sigma, there'd always be a little bit of an adjustment there. When you come out of the item screen in Sigma, you have to, in black, you can come out of the item screen and then just hold block and you won't absorb any essence. In Sigma, you have to, like, buffer in the block. You have to, like, press circle, and then block almost at the same time, or else when you come out of the item screen, you'll absorb the essence. And that was something that, when I first played Sigma, was like a real big adjustment. I was like, oh, that's weird. Like, why'd they do that?
Golly, I can't tell you. 2007 might have been the last time I played Sigma.
So, that guy, fortunately, again, sometimes these guys can survive 4 UTs. I forget here, but that UT actually knocks him back and out of the range there, so you do actually have to jump forward here. I think I knocked this guy out in 3, but these guys can survive 4 UTs, and as you can see, if you get 4 on both, you actually do have enough time here to get 4 UTs, as that second one I did actually whiffed.
I always have a hard time doing that.
What, the essence dragging?
Trying to pull the essence towards you.
It is quite strict timing.
Dang. Strict and timing in the same sentence. Oh, man. I had no chance.
I always forget this. I always equip the weapons I need, and then I forget that you have to do this little shortcut. Where you jump over the jet steam, the steam jets. So I've got my explosive arrows here, and I'm thinking, oh yeah, wait, I need shurikens here. Can you remember who first showed this shortcut?
Man, I don't know. My default for everything is Kiori.
Yeah, I actually can't remember. I mean, it probably was him. I don't know. I really can't remember if it was. But usually, obviously, you'd have to, shimmy along the thing, which is just stupid.
Well, I'll still do it sometimes, because for some reason, I don't even think about it.
You know what would be really cool in this game? I don't know how it... I'd love for someone to, kind of somehow just... On like a, maybe a modded Xbox, put it in. Would it be cool? How would it work if you could double jump? You think double jump's a really common action game thing, isn't it? In most action games, you can somehow, there is a way you can double jump. This is one of the few where you can't. You can jump wall jump, but you can't just double jump. I wonder how it'd affect movement. It'd be pretty cool. If you could jump in the air in a different direction, so you could roll to the left, jump forward, then jump backwards. So cool.
We're so good at that, so
it'd make Ryu
be awesome at it.
It'd make Ryu
I'd
even
still
more
be wall, I'd still be I'd still be wall shimmering.
So the reason I put in an elixir here is because if you fall in the lava and you burn a talisman, that's not great. It's not the end of the world on normal, but you don't really want it happening. And it's just irritating when it happens. That always makes me laugh.
It really is kind of disheartening in a sense, too.
Yeah.
It's I survived all these things and fell in the lava, and that's how I lose my...
I mean, I know we've mentioned it before, but people, again, when the game was new, people really struggled with with like the movement stuff in this game. You know, the movement, as good as the movement is, I don't think it's very intuitive. Like, you know, you do have to practice quite a bit. It's not like you can just pick up the game and, you know, like move really well. Like, it does take a lot of practice. And yeah, like lava jumps, you know, there was lava jump tutorials, you know, how to jump around the lava. Because, I mean, if you fall in it like two or three times, that was a really stupid move right there. You just got greedy. And if you fall in it two or three times, it's a fair amount of damage that you take.
Like I said, you and Kel probably have the best movement.
So here,
I'll make it look so easy.
Is this, you couldn't have timed that sentence better. Because here, I was trying to get a little fancy, and I was thinking, okay, I'll jump over this switch, like, you know, at the right angle, and then I'll windmill shuriken. But I actually was a little bit too much to the left, so I actually missed the jump. But it turned out it didn't matter, because he died anyway. But yeah, that was just funny timing.
Timing's everything.
It's funny, like, these long karma run, like, these long take karma run videos, if you, like, look at the amount of time, like, spent in encounters versus, like, saving items, like, there's so little time actually doing fights.
Oh, yeah.
That'll change on the high difficulties. Oh yeah, I think I ended up killing the rat somehow, so I thought that was funny, so I thought I'd just drag his essence.
Oh, nice.
With sound on, you'll hear him dissolve. I jump over, I think I do the air destruction slash, and I think I caught the rat. I just thought that was funny. But yeah, that'll definitely change on the high difficulties. It's why I think normal and hard, and even Ninja Dog, I think they're probably the most fun to karma run, because even though, you know, they are tough because the time limits are short, you just don't have to farm stuff, and it's the farming that really, you know, that really gets to me, at least. Like, it's, you know, when you've got, you know, 200 seconds and you're just trying to farm the shit
200
out
seconds
of
for four ogres or something.
Yeah, you know, something just crazy like that. You think, oh, you know, do we really need, like, you know, 3 minutes? But yeah, that stuff is really frustrating. Whereas on the lower difficulties, you know, you don't really have anything like that. Like these fights right here, you know, imagine if these fights had like 500 seconds. You know, you think, oh great, you know, I gotta farm these guys for like one hit lunar UTs. You know, it's just not right. Fun. It's funny in that regard, actually, to give NG2 some praise, because like, that game gets a bad rap in my book. I really wish that game had time limits, because when you actually play that game for score against most enemies, the instant kill killing spree systems make it super fun to play for score, but the thing that kills it is that there's no time limits, so it's always better to, you know, use the Kusarigama and get like a billion one-hit UTs. But chaining like your instant kill killing spree bonuses together with like counter-attacks, windmill shuriken, projectile UTs, that is so much fun, it's so satisfying, but it's by far like the least optimal way to play that game for score, which sucks.
Right.
It's a real shame that game doesn't have time limits.
I think that was probably one of my biggest downfalls when somebody, you know, scored like 70 million, then 80 million, then 90 million, stood back and shot the fish with UT arrows and then go by. I'm like, okay, that's a little much. At least here with time limits, you know, you have a limited amount and that's it. I mean,
yeah, and even even spawns too, because NG2, encounters didn't have like an environment, you know, you could chain encounters together. You know, you could just like, if there was say three ninja fights in, you know, a certain area, you could just spawn all three and then they, you know, like all three lots would be there at the same time. You know, you can't do that in this game. If you go out of an environment, the enemies despawn.
Right.
Which is probably a system restraint, actually, because you think this game probably can't handle like 50 enemies on screen. Whereas in NG2, of course, you know, it was a much more powerful system. Like, you know, they could actually do that. Well, actually, they couldn't. They thought they could. That game's frame rate goes to shit whenever there's loads of enemies on screen.
Right.
Someone should have told them that, you know? It's like, hey, just because you can do this doesn't mean you should. So I think this is just boss fights now. Again, just jump in the lava. Ryu with his legs of steel. That's all you need, you know? How much do you think Ryu, like, squats with them legs? And just stand in lava. just like squats a tank. I just like doing that. I think it's really funny. You know, you just jump over and he like grabs the edge. It just looks funny.
I was watching the guy on Mixer. I mean, obviously he was new, but he actually would run, you know, after the fire, after you slide down into the ice, and he would actually jump down into the pit and then wall run up and then go over and save. And I was just like, you know, you can just jump over that little chasm.
Oh, man. So Jotunfrau is actually worth quite a lot of points, as you see there. It's a very short time limit. The general strategy is just open with this string right here. You can finish it with, like, you know, the XXXX. But as you can see there, that hold down Y, like the UT animation, like the ET move, just with no essence, it does way more damage, and then you can just kill him virtually in one more hit. And again, if you're saving like 2 seconds when your seconds are worth over 2,000 points, you know, you want to save that time.
Now that's just a great spirit elixir in there, but on hard, it's your, yep, either hard or very hard. It's your Inazuma, I think.
I think it's on hard, yeah. Yeah, they give you that really late. That's such a broken Nimpo when you think about it.
Oh, I love it.
It's so powerful. You know, if you're just playing the game new, like if you're new to the game, like when you get that in Chapter 10, every single fight after that, if you wanted to, you could just Inazuma it. Like, and it'd kill everything straight away.
X there.
Yeah,
you
but like,
fall him in the lava.
That was intentional to get my low health UF, man.
Right.
Like, you know, come on. Like, I didn't miss the jump there.
No. I'm talking about whenever you jump to do the X to make sure you got on the land, because you surely didn't want to lose your rebirth. I've done that before. Or run into this without saving or something. I mean,
make sure. I think there's a great spirit elixir in that chest. There's a scarab to your left. Make sure you grab this great devil elixir. Now, the worm, there's a couple of ways you can do the worm. Again, the worm is worth a lot of points. You can, do it the same way you do the electric worm. So just, like, roll ET. I like doing it. I think it's just more fun, and it's kind of funny. Open with a flying swallow. He has to do, the flame wheel attack, or that attack right there. If he just kind of stands there and does nothing, when you flying swallow him, he tends to jump in. But he misses that right there. But then he comes out again, though. But I just fire wheel through it. I just thought that looked really cool. So,
wow, that was very cool.
It's not faster, though. Like, you can get 195 on the kill bonus there. If you just flying swallow him and then that entire rotate Y hits him. Because sometimes if you get enemies near a wall, that rotate Y can do like an extra hit where Ryu kind of brings it up to swing it down. That can hit them as well. And if that entire string hits that worm, he dies. But again, there, like that extra hit didn't actually hit him. I just thought that looked cool. So I thought, yeah.
Oh, it was. It was very cool.
Although looking at it now, if I'd have got that extra 2,000 points, look at my score.
Oh,
I hate seeing
exactly
that. I'd be at 890. You know, and that's how you know you're getting hooked on karma running. You know when you look at your score and you're thinking, oh, that's 8.7, but if I'd have got that ET, it'd be 8.9. You know, you're just looking at the number. You know, you don't care about anything else. You're just looking at the numbers and thinking, well, that'd be a higher number if I'd have got those points.
That a little platforming after the worm. I can't tell you how many times I fail that. And just, it's like, really, I'm gonna miss out my chapter book because I can't swing across it. A bar.
So, I cannot remember the last time I watched this cutscene, but it is really cool. I remember when my first time through the game, and I remember thinking, like, oh, end of the chapter, thank God. And then, you know, they're like, oh, yeah, by the way, here's a dragon. Have fun. I'm like, oh, shit. But fortunately, that was 14 years ago. Now we can just do this. And just,
right,
you know, tell him it was boss. You do have a lot of time in that that fight, so you can farm UTs if you want. But looking at how much the time, I think it's 119 on the clock. You get 205,000 doing it that way, so you'd have to get 90,000 in UTs to make UTs worthwhile. And I mean, that's, what's that, 18 UTs? I don't think you're going to get 18 in that time. And that's basically it for chapter 12. It's a pretty long chapter, but once you get to the caverns, it's actually quite short. This is just me managing my essence. In hindsight, I should have put what my starting essence was. I'll probably do that in the subsequent videos, like for the other difficulties. Just so that, you know, people have an idea of what to buy and that. But again, just always write it down if you forget. Keep your first save after the chapter. That's the best way to do that. Then you can always go back to that save and have a look at how much money you had. But again, just play it as close as you can. You know, you really want to keep it tight going forward, as it really, really pays dividends in chapter 15 and 14.
Well, again, how smart he was to save after the fight, but before he went to Miramasa. So if he accidentally went over, then hey, let me just reload the save versus having to go and fight Smoggin over again. Yep.
So again, what I was saying about the numbers, it's a perfect example right here. You know, if I'd have got here and I was at like 13089, I'd be furious. Because like here, I know, I'm thinking, yeah, I'm going to be at 13.4. Whereas if I had 6,000 less points, it'd be 13.3, and that score's just terrible.
Great essence management there.
So, yeah, 28.70. I think the time limit's 42 minutes, so 41.59. But again, you know, I've still got a bit of time, so you could still save or, you know, do a bit more essence management if you need to or whatever. So you have still got a little bit of time to play with. So that's just something to keep in mind. You could also do those. You could probably fit in those two other fights in the city, actually, thinking about it. However, that's not too big a deal, as it's quite easy to fit them in Chapter 13. But this is just preparing for the Wasp Challenge. And then just go back here and save. Don't save at the save statue at the Wasps, otherwise it will remove the time limit when you load it. And that is it, guys. We'll see you in Chapter 13. Hope you enjoyed
it. Take care, everyone.